Hey everyone, Johnny here. In this quick tip video, we're going to see how we can use a geometry node's attribute proximity node to do a cool material shift on an object. In this example, whenever I move this icosphere near this Suzanne head, the texture will change from this rock texture to this chrome texture. Let's jump into the Blender scene. Here you can see I've got the Suzanne and I've got the icosphere, and as I move it, I get the material shift. Let's take a look on how to set this up. With the Suzanne head selected, I'm going to add a new geometry node tree, and I'm going to add an attribute proximity node. Then I also want to reference this icosphere in my node tree. I could add an object input node and then point it to the icosphere, or I can drag the icosphere from my outliner down into my geometry nodes. Because I want to use the actual position of the icosphere, make sure you set the position to relative. I'm going to use the icosphere as the target of my attribute proximity. And we'll just call the input D for distance. This is the absolute bare minimum we need to do this material shift. So let's go over to the shading menu. Adding a new material to our Suzanne, we're going to add in a duplicate principled shader, and then we're going to add a mix shader to mix these two principled shaders. For right now, I'm going to set this top one to be metallic, and I'll set the bottom one to be, say, this blue color. So now using the mix shader, I can either be this chrome or this blue. Next, I want to add in an attribute, and we'll set this to use the D attribute. Now, when I move the icosphere near the Suzanne, you'll see that it starts to change to the second material. Now, because the chrome material is in the first slot, when the factor coming into the mix shader is 0, it'll choose this top material. When it's 1, it'll choose the bottom one. So, since this is based on the distance, as the distance generated by our proximity node gets closer and closer to 0, it will change more and more to the chrome, and we can start to see the effect. But we want to amplify this effect. Let's go ahead and do it in our geometry nodes. From here, I could choose an attribute math node. One way to add contrast to a number is to raise that number to a given exponent. We can do that using the power function. Taking D and raising it to the power that we have in B, we'll see we can get a very localized change. Now when we move our icosphere, we're getting an effect we'd like. In this material, this side of my shader was built using a PBR texture imported with Node Wrangler, and this side is just a chrome material. Here you can see I'm driving the mix shader with the attribute, but I'm also driving this mix for the displacement with the same attribute. This way, when the material gets close and it chooses the top shader, also choosing to wipe out the displacement. So I get a nice smooth texture, but when it moves away, it returns to a bumpy texture. Anyhow, I hope this gives you some really great ideas. I hope it inspires you to make something awesome. Thanks for checking out this video. Make sure to like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I'll see you next time.